Yes, let's look at roughly what is checked in the sperm test. You gave sperm to a container for sperm testing. What is in this semen? The general appearance of semen is checked. Color, turbidity if any, odor, then liquefaction time are the criteria. I will explain this in a moment. Viscosity is checked. Viscosity of semen is checked. The semen volume is measured. Then, microscopy of the sperm is examined through a special slide. Here, the speed, shape, and number of the sperm cell is checked, and whether there are leukocytes and round cells, if any, is examined. Now, look, I put in a normal sperm sample. It's a sperm cell. How should normal sperm be? There are criteria here, of course. Important experts in the subject evaluate them. I am one of them. With special dyes, it is evaluated whether it is this way. Healthy sperm should look like this. How should the menu look? This is a sample of semen. The appearance is homogeneous, i.e. not cloudy, usually white or gray in color, sometimes yellowish opaque. If, for any reason, there is bleeding in the testicular tract and the path of sperm, this color may turn red or brown. In the case of jaundice or the use of vitamins, especially B vitamins or other drugs that dye body fluids, semen may turn into an extremely yellow color. It is not very important. Now, in the sperm test, you may have seen, if there are those who have had it, there may be high leukocyte levels. What does leukocyte mean? Look, here is the sperm cell. Those are leukostases. Normally, the leukocyte count in the semen and sperm sample should be 1 million/mL or less. High leukocyte levels usually indicate an infection in the testicular tract. In other words, in different testicular diseases such as epididymitis and orchitis, leukocytes may be elevated in the sperm sample. What should be the volume of semen, that is, the volume of semen for sperm? In general, it should be between 1 and 6.5 milliliters. If it is 1 milliliter or less, this is usually a problem. There is a kind of bag in which semen is made, which we call the seminal vesicle. Here, semen volume may decrease below 1 in case of an obstruction or dysfunction. Again, agglutination is measured in the sperm test. What is agglutination? If there is agglutination, look here, the sperm cells are stuck to each other. This is agglutination. It also has degrees, such as grade 2, 3. Agglutination should not normally be in the sperm test. If present, it may be an autoimmune reaction. In other words, there may be some autoimmune diseases, there may be some antibodies against sperm cells. If there is agglutination, some other tests are done. Of course, what is the importance of agglutination? If there is agglutination, the chance of pregnancy will be less because the sperm will stick together, so it is an undesirable situation that slightly increases the risk of infertility. Viscosity is also checked in the sperm test. What is viscosity? See an example of this. The normal semen sample becomes liquid after about 1 hour, so it should drip like this. If it stretches 2 centimeters or more like a rubber, that is viscous. If it is not fluid, we call it increased viscosity. If the viscosity increases, that is, its fluidity decreases, this reduces the chance of pregnancy as it will impair sperm movement and increases the risk of infertility. An increase in viscosity is not desirable. Liquefaction time is also measured in the sperm test. Normally, sperm is the time it takes for the semen sample to become liquid. Normally, it becomes liquid within 1 hour. If it exceeds 1 hour, if it is still not liquid, we call it liquefaction defect. Of course, just like agglutination, it prevents the sperm from reaching the egg, which is considered an important problem. What is one of the most important parameters, sperm count or concentration? Now, for sperm, the World Health Organization would have considered it normal to have at least 20 million sperm per milliliter, but today that number has been reduced to 15 million. In other words, having at least 15 million sperm per milliliter is now considered normal and sufficient. We call the sperm count less than 15 million oligospermia. What is azoospermia? It is the state of not having any sperm in the semen. Of course, it is checked first, then if there is no sperm again, that sample is centrifuged and examined again. If no sperm is seen again, we call it azoospermia. Azoospermia is a very serious cause of infertility because there is no sperm. Why is sperm count important? The less sperm count, the less chance of pregnancy. That's why we say there should be a minimum of 15 million sperm, but the more the better. What should be motility, sperm motility? The movement is evaluated after 1 hour, that is, the sample is given, and we look at the movements after 1 hour. After 60 minutes, that is, 1 hour, the rate of motile sperm should be 40% and above. Again, the rate of progressively moving sperm should be at least 32%. If the motility feature is never, that is, if the sperms are less mobile, we call this asthenospermia. This is just like the number of sperm, that is, the more sperm movements, the higher the chance of pregnancy. For him, this is an important parameter. Shape, i.e. morphology, is checked in the sperm test. This is viewed in two ways, Kruger morphology made by a scientist called Kruger or according to the criteria of the World Health Organization. Here, just like the number or movement, the worse the shape of the sperm, the higher the probability of infertility. Therefore, the shape of the sperm must be good. How is the Kruger test evaluated? For example, if the morphology, that is, the shape is 15% and above, as a result of staining, that is, the well-shaped sperms are 15% and above, it is normal, there is no problem. If it's 15% and below, we call it the lower mid-range. Of course, since the shape is bad, the chance of fertilization is low. If the figure is 4% and below, then the chance of pregnancy decreases, then of course in vitro fertilization or microinjection treatment can be tried.